Good afternoon. So it's Saturday afternoon. I'm just going to try and get a little bit of fertilizer out today. I'm trying to get it out on our silage ground. We've got a couple of fields done already, so we've about 22 acres done, and we've got another just a little less than 20 to do. So and that'll be all our first cut silage ground, then will be fertilised. This was all slurried around 2 weeks ago, or just less than 2 weeks ago. So yeah, there has been a little bit of rain, and a lot of it has been washed in, but you can still see little bits of slurry on just below the grass line. So we do need another little bit of rain to get all this stuff washed in. We just build up the revs. We're in 540 economy, so we reach 540 revolutions at just less than 1700 revs. So a little bit easier on fuel than if you were doing it on full revs. So we're just driving and just dropping the fertiliser to the edge of the hedgerow, or that's where I'm aiming to drop it. I have got a limiter on this fertiliser spreader, but I'm not using it at the minute. It has been very blustery and windy all day, and actually I can just see now we've got a tree down here in the corner. So I'm going to have to go over and lift that before we do any of the rolling here. We will roll this land here whenever it rains a little bit, just when the ground gets softened up a wee bit. But yeah, it's been very windy and blustery all day, and I had been a little bit nervous about spreading today because with the wind I thought maybe the coverage might be 100%, but yeah, no issues at all. The first field that I done, I just walked it and checked that the spreader was spreading at the right pattern and at full coverage, and it was. There was no issue, so happy enough to continue on spreading. I was hoping to try and get the fertiliser out today because we've got some rain coming, possibly overnight or tomorrow. So yeah. Just be nice to get it out before the rain comes. When you're spreading fertilizer now at this time, it usually gives you a nice opportunity when you're driving around to just check how the field is doing, as in weed wise. See what weeds we have, or what maybe we'll have to spray with. This field's not too bad. One of the previous fields that I've already done, it had quite a bit of chickweed, so we're going to have to address that. I seen maybe about 10 or 12 docks out through it as well, so we'll have to try and get it that the spray will also address the docks. This field here now is rather clean. It was sprayed last year. I see a few thistles back there, which is unusual. We don't usually have many thistles. There's a few thistles, so we'll have to address them. And there's actually another thistle here. There is a few docks out through it in places. So it just gives you a good chance to assess what you have coming up along with the grass. And then in a couple of weeks then, when we're spraying the grassland, we can then address any issues that we have with weeds. So yeah, I'll spread on at this. I'm spreading at, just to let you know, I'm spreading at 370 kilos a hectare, which in old money is a 350 kg bags per acre. the ground did get more than 2,000 gallons of slurry already. I'd say somewhere between two and a half and 3,000, I would say, would be what it would have gotten. So, we don't need any more than around 370 kilos per hectare. That'll be plenty. So I'll continue on and set up the camera outside, get a little bit of footage, and come back to me at the end. So I'm just, after finishing off all the spreading here in this field, just had to have a look at the tree and what damage it done when it came down. And it done plenty. It has broke some of the wire. Looks like the tree has been fairly rotten now for a while. I'm going to have to lift it. I can pull it. There is like a bit of a waste area in here where I can dump it in. So yeah, have to do that before the grass gets on too much further, and before we do any of the land rolling. So it's another job that has to be done. So I'm just going to head back now to the yard.